If there's an offer, I'll come.
Yeah.
All right, a few words about this three-day hike we did in the last days of August. So obviously this was not a solo hike, and I think that's first on this channel. No, I joined a friend this time, and I have to say she was a good sport about waiting for me every time I had to run back to get my camera. So we hiked for 3 days along the French Opal Coast, about 83 kilometers in total, mostly along the famous GR120 trail. You'll find the exact route in the Strava links below in the description. It's absolutely a wonderful region, and it's just great to hike along a rugged coastline instead of the usual mountains or forests. I was actually surprised there was so much variation on this hike. Some villages can get a little touristy, but they're still small. They're very quaint, very picturesque. We wild camped 3 nights, and it did get a little challenging to find a flat and secluded spot for the 2 tents every night. We even got lucky with the French police on day 2. Yeah, but sleeping in the dunes, gazing at the amazing sunsets and sunrises on the beach, watching the lights of the ships in the distance, that's just chef's kiss. We also had great weather, but you're often very exposed to the sun, and winds can be absolutely brutal as well. Now, in terms of gear, you know, I've been upgrading my kit piece by piece, getting better and more lightweight things like my sleeping quilt, my new big Agnes tent, which I'm very happy with so far. There's one piece of gear, however, that is still kind of traditional, and that's my backpack. So last year I came across the Dutch brand Herder Gear, and they're a small company, just a group of friends that started making a lightweight backpack. Now there are many options out there of these kinds of frameless minimal backpacks below 1 kilogram, but what I liked about Herder Gear is that their stuff is produced locally, sustainably. The thing is though, I had never used the backpack without a frame before, so I got in touch with them and they got me this Zino backpack right here to test, to do a hike with. So what's it like to hike with a frameless pack? Well, for starters, I wouldn't recommend a pack like this if you're carrying like 15 kilograms of gear. No, these are designed for base weights, I'd say below 7-8 kilograms maximum. For this hike, I had a base weight of about 5.5 kilos. So with all the food, water and gas, it was at most about 10 kilograms at the start of the hike. There's a link to my full gear list on lighterpack.com below. So yeah, honestly, it felt great. It's a lightweight, compact backpack. I really thought it was comfortable. It has one big roll top closure and 2 side bags that you can reach while carrying the backpack. So that's ideal for a water bottle, a filter. There's also a big mesh in the front and 2 large optional belt pouches. It comes with a removable piece of back protection that also doubles as a really convenient seat pad. It should be waterproof, but fortunately I couldn't test that. One disadvantage of packs like these is that there is pretty much no ventilation on your back, so it will get sweaty. This one is also not one of the lightest one. I think it comes in about just under 1 kilogram. But this was my first hike with a frameless minimal backpack like this, so this is not a comprehensive review at all. But I have to say I was quite surprised, and I would like to thank Herder Gear for this test. You can find them at herdergear.com. That link is also below in the description. So that's it. We're in the final days of summer here, but I'm actually looking forward to fall and winter conditions. I hope to do some more hiking soon, and in the meantime you should follow me on Instagram, drop a comment or a like below, share it with a friend, subscribe if you're new here, and I'll catch you soon.